Hello and welcome back to Shadowrun Returns. I'm getting close to the end, I can feel it. The cold utilitarian facilities of the Brotherhood's private areas break away and degenerate into sprawling subterranean tunnels that were not crafted by the hands of man. The air is foul with the smell of decaying flesh and something else, a rank, stinging acid bite that hits noses and eyes hard. Wet, squirming noises echo throughout the tunnels, punctuated by the low moans and the occasional gasp. For what, you can't tell. One thing you can tell, though, Aegis works. You shoulder your launcher and keep going. I don't know why it said that I can continue and it's sit here. There we go. Oh, I got karma. Alright. Harlequin says, we continue on down into the belly of the beast. Perhaps you should construct an epic poem about our adventure here. It would not be the first written about me, to be sure. I shall consider it now. Onward! You hear him muttering rhymes to himself as he walks. At least I can keep everyone together now. The poor little drones. I think the one is still out of commission. Oh wait, we still have to move in... Ugh, it's fucking dumb. I can't believe we still have to move like that. I don't feel like something's gonna come out of there. Okay, there you go. Well, at least the drone is restored. At least a little. Dun, 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 dun. Holy shitballs. Well, I'm gonna get you away from there. Oh, he has the launcher equipped. Well, shit. I'll just leave you here. I didn't realize it was the drone's turn already. Why can't I shoot him? Can't I shoot? Oh wait, I'm on my drone. Derp. Site blocked, so I'll go for that. Or I can move over here. Go for him. Now I'll just shoot this guy. Oh, fuck me. I forget to switch their weapons. Glad they're missing though. Oh my god, really? What in the fuck? That one's bigger. Ah! God. This is probably really bad positioning. Oh well. Alright, Harlequin, I want you to reload. And then I want you to overwatch this way. You, I would like. Oh, you can't shoot that thing? Really? I'll move you. Still missing, so that's good. No! I wanted you to overwatch this fucker. Really? Oh, damn. Okay. Are you fucking kidding me? Oh god, I thought I was still on this guy. Fuck me. God damn it. Move my drone a bit. Nice. Maybe, oh my god. And maybe we can take these assholes out. Go Pixel.
Yay. All right, guy. Nothing you can do, drone, so just... Ooh. This is gonna be risky. Ah, fuck. Fuck you. Oh wait, no. I still have this guy. Good. See what we've all got. Sword Overwatch. Why I can't stand there. That's odd. Oh shit. That's not good. I might actually have him come out of this vent. I haven't been able to use that yet. Oh, they have a mage. Oh shit. I'm gonna go for this person first. Sword fighting time. Oh man, your health is so low. Cool. Alright, Pixel, take out the mage. Or not. Fuck. Alright, drone, it's up to you. There we go. What? Why can't I come out here? Okay, well that was pretty shitty of the game to make it look like I could do that. Now it's cost me a turn. Yay. Oh, well, it's okay. This guy's not very good. Anybody dying on me. Not so close to the end. Miss. Oh well. Fucking kidding me. Step up your shit. Oh my god. Yeah, get out of there. You know what, just get all the way out of there. Ando, they are immortal bugs. I'm trying to stop them. There is no good place to put you. Or you. Fucking hell. Yeah, I think it's a mixture of eggs and gore, to be honest. Oh my god. I don't want any of that business. Alright, time to make yourself useful. Fucking mana ball this. There we go. I think I really needed to do that. Yeah, so I have these special weapons that I need in order to kill the immortal bugs. Sure, I'll use them in a minute. God, no one's hitting anything. Something like that. It's like a can of raid that transcends the astral planes as well as the regular world. Oh, my extra person's gonna die. See if I can take out this shooter. There we go. And run away. Yeah, run away. Like, get him anyway. Damn it. Oh, I don't want to know what that is. Oh, shit. Are you fucking kidding me? This is ridiculous. Honestly, don't quite know what to do right now. Yeah, but yeah, this is the gun that kills the bugs when they're in their spirit form. Oh god, this is the worst. Oh, thank God. Okay. Well, fuck you, drone. No, not again! Oh my God.
Damn it.
See what you've got. Good. Ha. Alright. Gonna move you over here now. No! Come on, drone. God. Again. Fucking hell. Oh well. How am I missing every single shot? There we go. God damn it. If I don't kill it in a single round, then it comes back to life. And then I have to kill the thing all over again. And this guy and the drone don't have guns that can kill these things. Silly. Oh well. Might as well kill that thing. There's nothing for the drone to do. I guess I'll put him on Overwatch for when this guy comes back to life. That did a lot of good. How are you missing? Yeah, this is fucking useless. Well, I'll put him on Overwatch for when that guy comes back now. It's ridiculous. Finally. Whether or not you shoot seems like it's so random sometimes. Everyone? Really? You got everyone with that? My god. Nice. Overwatch actually hit. Fucking dicks. Oh my god. Finally. I really hope I don't have to heal anymore. Cause this is all I've got. Doesn't really look like anything too threatening is going on up there. Huh, alright. Everything looks okay still, but I don't quite trust it. Just in case, have 3 AP. That's interesting. their enemies in there. Sword Overwatch time. Or actually, no. Actually, I'm gonna move back a bit. So they can't actually get me without moving. And Pixel can go. Not there. Alright, you can go. Shit. I should have just kept this person here. Oh well. Alright, you can go here. I think you want Overwatch. Pixel can go here. I don't know how that's three moves. That seems a bit much. He can't move very far either. Drone there. Not exactly ideal with his shotgun, but I have nowhere to put him. I have you on Overwatch with a sword! Oh wait, no, I moved you out of the way. Never mind. I was wrong. Really? There we go. Oh, I almost shot her with my insect gun. That wouldn't have been good. You know what? Fuck that. Stab you. Now I'll put you on Sword Overwatch. Still can't really go anywhere. Debating whether I should start stabbing that guy or whether I should move Pixel up. I'll move Pixel up. Put you on Sword Overwatch again. You can go here and be on Overwatch. He still can't go very far. That's okay. I'll stab him now. Okay, maybe now. There we go. Ooh, got a gold trauma kit. So one of us will very likely go down. Loot everywhere though. Give me the loot. Grenade? I don't want a grenade. Give me a medkit. Cool. Two medkits, that's nice. A locked safe that has both a card reader and a data jack. I will hack it with my decking. What do I get? Ooh, platinum trauma kit. Okay, pretty good. Are these in my inventory? Wait a minute. Do they go to the inventory of the person who picks it up? Fucking dicks. I wish I knew that. Don't make me regret using this on you. Door unlocked. Let's go, people. Honestly, I don't know if two med kits and a trauma kit, or no, two trauma kits are gonna cut it. Don't know why it didn't let Pixel leave. It let her walk past the door for some reason. The Bug Shaman. A rhythmic thrumming punctuates the air, passing through you, vibrating your lungs and your chest, and making it hard to breathe. It's an electricity that makes the hair on your skin stand up in protest. Ahead, you hear the sounds of chanting, accented by the moist wriggling of larvae. There are low rumbles too, stone on stone. The sense of imminence is everywhere. Something is coming, and it has to be stopped. Actually, now that I think about it, I only have one med kit now. I had to use one right away. Ugh. There you are, you bitch. Do I have to, like, walk right up to you? Jessica appears to be in the throes of a violent trance or mild seizure. A manic state brought on by the terrible energy she is attempting to conduct. Pixel, stop! The queen approaches the vessel, the summoning. We cannot be disturbed. Your vessel's gone. This is over, Jessica. Jessica's eyes roll back in her head. Whatever magic she is channeling is fast approaching a crescendo. Lynn speaks in her place. You may have taken Marie Louise, our chosen, but another Telestrian will take her place. I give myself willingly. I will be host to our queen and the mother of a new world. See what these things can do, Lynn. This queen will devour you, body and soul, but I don't think you care about that. Harlequin makes an exaggerated grimace. And then crap out a few billion young, blech. No, I will become a perfect being. Through me and through my sacrifice, a new age will begin. When Jessica speaks next, her eyes have a disturbing sharpness. Her words are echoed by Lynn in a manner that suggests a connection beyond their shared zealotry. The hive has no thought beyond hunger, no goal beyond reproduction. We are one. When I end you, it'll be good for my conscience and my cred stick. Jessica's body then suddenly spasms, arching her back and nearly lifting her off her feet. She lets loose a scream, falling somewhere between elation and agony. The queen is near. You know what? I forgot that this person has a healing spell. That could have saved me some med kits. Fuck me. Oh God. I'm guessing I can attack Jessica and I can attack the pillar? This is weird. Alright, let's find out what I'm doing then. Oh my god, that barely took anything. Going to heal you. Okay, well, the healing spell's not very good, so at least I don't feel too bad about this. I wonder if I have to shoot the insect pillar with my ray gun. Nope, immune. Okay, so it has to be destroyed by normal means. Alright, Justin, that's where you come in. Maybe. I don't know. Hold on a minute. Okay. Oh, it's sleeping? What does that mean? I don't want to know what that means. Oh, I should have brought my drone on. Shit. That! Oh, it's another one? This is horrid. Alright, I'll shoot Jessica. Oh, okay, so I do need to shoot the insect pillar. She's drawing power from that thing! Alright, I'll remember that. If I die and I have to do this again, I will remember to shoot the insect pillar right away. But for now, it looks like I'll need to shoot this thing. Alright. Just in case. Oh, wait, you're not Justin. I think a spell is in order. There we go. Oh yeah, I need to summon my drone before I forget. There you go, little buddy. Okay, well that was useless. That wasn't. Cool. I'll get that thing. I hope you other guys hit. I'm gonna reload my real weapon instead, though. Oh my god, not another one! I'm so tired of these things. So tired of them. Oh, and the insect pillar's back up. Fuck. I'm probably gonna have to start this over just because I didn't know what I was doing. Okay then. What? It's immune. Okay, well then I'll shoot her. Oh good. Okay, cool. shoot it with that. Nope, it's immune. Why is it immune to everything? It was immune to a normal gun, and it was immune to this. Drone can't hit shit. Oh, and there we all go. Or they, I guess. Oh my god. Is there no end? Why is that thing immune? Fuck me. I didn't mean to shoot it with that. Alright, I'll try a spell. Actually, oh, I don't have any more repair kits either. Maybe only one insect pillar is open at once, and I have to go after them. That would be really fucking annoying, though. Though I wouldn't put that past any video game to do something that annoying. Oh my god, how are you so low? Wait, can they not move? Wait a minute. Why can't anyone? Oh, okay. Nice. It's a good hit. Oh god. Oh, he missed. Oh, good thing. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna shoot Jessica for a bit. Well, so much for that. Alright. Use a repair kit. Heal a drone. And then you have a med kit, right? No? Who has the med kit? Oh, the drone actually does, I think. What?! Someone had one. Maybe it's me. No, it's not. That's really weird. I know I didn't use it. Oh well. What the fuck? Is that even going down at all? I think it is. Yeah. One HP. Awesome. Ugh. That sound makes it seem like someone's knocking at my door. I don't know why you keep missing, but I'm glad. Reload his gun last time. Oh my god. There we go. Okay. Getting so close. Nice. have my heal back. I do. Cool. I don't know why it's 1 HP. That's such bullshit. Maybe I, like, healed him already, and it doesn't let me heal him more than a certain amount? I don't know. Nice. A good hit. Alright, this isn't going as badly as I thought it would. It's not going too great, but it's not going bad. Kinda having to hold out. Just thought I'd try it. I don't know why the drone misses so much when he has a 79% chance. Fucking really. Not even in cover or anything. Cool. I'm gonna heal. Have him heal himself, since... Alright. Kill this bitch, but not with the bug gun. There we go. Come on! There we go. Okay, that was alright. Yeah, that's okay. Give yourself 20 HP because, you know, I'll get more out of you. Don't really expect him to hit with a shotgun from there, but that's okay. Oh, he hit her a little bit. Ooh. Aw. Ooh. You have ruined everything! Really? Eliminate the- wait a minute. What did I- Okay, well I completed a bunch of stuff, apparently. The once beautiful Jessica Watts is a hollow shell of her former self. Her skin is pale, her lips are ashen, and her eyes are sunken in her skull. It is more than her body's reaction to the physical damage she sustained or the strain of channeling magical power from another plane of existence. There is something missing from her now. It's gone, my link to the Queen. She has abandoned me, expelled me. Unworthy, unworthy. Whatever pain you're feeling is far less than what you deserve. She hugs herself and begins shaking uncontrollably, little cries of anguish and despair escaping her chest. I know, I will go to hell for this. If I still have a soul at all, I betrayed humanity. Oh, she actually feel bad? Her tear-streaked face freezes with a sudden realization. Oh god, the other nests, they're in every major city. What have we done? And Sam, I'm so sorry, Sam. Oh my god. Jessica looks at you pleading, please, Pixel, don't let them eat me. Do nothing but watch, kill her before the bugs do. Take her with you. They'll eat you, but Sam is gonna get justice first. What? No, please don't! You emerge from the Universal Brotherhood chapter house, momentarily blinded by the bright lights of the Lone Star perimeter surrounding the exit. Despite the clean night air, the stench of ichor and decay clings to you, a smell that may never fully go away. You drop your Aegis-filled shotgun, and it's quickly spirited away by one of Telestrian's minions. Weapons are slowly lowered as you step out into the street, the order coming from Detective McCluskey himself. You can see James Telestrian just nearby pulling his strings. It's over. Jessica Watts has been dealt with, and Sam has his justice. The dead man's deed is done. All you need now is to make a phone call and it ends. Well, I apparently got a bunch of karma for that, so I guess I'll spend it. Even though I don't really think much else is gonna happen. 30 karma, damn. Well, I'll just max out my decking. Decking god. Smartest person ever. Yeah, I'll get a new etiquette. Maybe. Let's see what else I can get first, actually. Maybe ranged combat so I don't miss so much. I don't know if that would help though, everyone seemed to miss a lot. You know what? I will get a new etiquette, just for the hell of it. Probably won't get to use it, but that's okay. Right, and I think I'll do body. Quickness. I need to be quick in order to not get killed. Okay. And after we broke up the ritual, Pixel chased Jessica into a small chamber where she was cornered by a couple of buggers. Guess they weren't impressed with her performance. They were about to eat her. And she killed her before they could do it. Some sort of street justice, I suppose. I don't know. I haven't been following the story closely. So the nest has been cleaned out, the shaman is dead, and your cousin Lynn is being transported to a mental hospital for observation. James assesses you with a newfound respect. Very clean. I believe our test of Project Aegis was a success, Pixel. Your Brackhouse is having it weaponized now for distribution to Knight Errant forces. The authorities are going to have a great many questions about the incident, and I will need to provide details. Universal Brotherhood has a great many chapter houses, and they must be dealt with immediately. What'll happen next? That is for others to determine. People other than you. Still, you have turned in a yeoman's effort, and regardless of your obvious flaws, you are deserving of a reward. What would you ask of me? McCluskey is a dick. I don't really want to be a... I'm thinking money. I just want to get paid. He smiles an icy smile. I would expect no less from you. Mr. Quoth, please place a suitable bonus on our friend's cred stick. A bonus of such size that additional negotiations are unnecessary. I have no interest in furthering our relationship. 100,000 yuan. Okay, not bad. Yes, sir. He takes your cred stick and slots it into his PDA. Looks like you two are best buddies now. The painted elf is watching the scene unfolding around the Universal Brotherhood with a grimace. Well, kid, it's been fun, but I've seen everything I care to see today. I'm gonna get out of here. Okay, seriously, who are you? A friend. Until I need you for something, then I'm a bastard. Is there a problem? He gestures at the crowd as he speaks. Look around. Note the members of the press being shuffled away by Universal Brotherhood spokespeople to get a private briefing. The Brotherhood is connected. A damage control team is probably on the way right now. Think they can control the press? One way or another, they will. If they can't be manipulated, coerced, or bribed, they'll probably disappear quietly. There's more, though. He nods his head toward James Telestrian. Note the expression on the UCAS FBI agent speaking to Telestrian. Dismissive, isn't it? That's because there's no lost love between the UCAS and Tier Tengu. They're not going to trust what he's telling them, and frankly, I have no idea what he's telling them. James plays his own game. Always has. How could James turn this to his advantage? Well, there's an economic incentive, for one. Power, for another. If there was an outbreak of bugs in a major city and his company had the only product capable of combating it, you think it might give him some sort of edge? I'm not saying he'd do that, but I am saying his field test results were quite compelling. Let me show you one more. He points at someone in the crowd and smiles. The man sees him, pointing and smiles back. That guy there? He's with Ares Macrotechnology. Enormous megacorp. Ridiculously powerful. They've been sniffing around Project Aegis for quite a while now. Clearly they have an agenda that's just starting to unfold. He gives the Ares man the finger. The man smiles and returns the gesture. Government, media, business. All working to ensure the truth stays hidden. Oh, it's a massive conspiracy. I wish it was. In a way, it's worse. It's a series of conspiracies, conflicting agendas, and petty jealousies, all building upon, feeding upon, and excreting
into the unending web of dreck that people wade through every day and call it life. If there was one Dark Lord controlling everything and we could drive a magic sword through his heart and free the world, that would be grand. Such clarity, such focus, alas. So what's the lesson in all of this? That I did it, all of it for nothing? He laughs. Just the opposite, schmuck. The lesson is this. The game is rigged. The cards are stacked. The dice are loaded. It's the same as it always was. Every cycle. People in power exert power. Little people cower in their homes, think what they're told to think, and buy whatever product will help them forget how horrible their lives are for another day. And that's why we don't play their fragging game. We don't swallow their dreck sandwich and politely ask for another. It's why we run the shadows. That's where real life is, kiddo. Reality's living in the places no one wants you to see. That was a bit too real. Anyway, where's Erbrekos? I thought he'd be here too. He flew back to Berlin. All sorts of things brewing there. He was very impressed with you, though. It could probably turn into work someday, but I'd forget about him if I were you. Never make a deal with a dragon kid. They're playing a different game entirely. See you around, Harley Quinn. Coyote, Jake, dress in that fucking weirdo. Do I have an objective? Not really. McCluskey's alternating between trying to look important and trying to avoid actual work. What are you looking at, Tube? Your shoes untied. Mr. McCluskey looks down at his shoes as you dive your knee into the bridge of his nose. He goes down with a thump. Nice. Jake shakes his head, smirking as you approach. When you finally get close, he breaks out laughing. I heard the Universal Brotherhood was getting shot up on the police scanner. Knew it had to be you. Did you get her? Oh, I got her. Figured you would. He scratches his mop of red hair. Guess that concludes the story of Pixel and the Dead Man's Switch, huh? You know, I've been thinking, maybe you should stay in Seattle a while. Plenty of ways folks like us can get into trouble here. You only skim the surface. I heard Mitsuhama's looking for a team, and they specifically want a woman. No idea what that's about. And I just got word that something's going on near Crater Lake. The Tears got it on total lockdown. No fly zone. The whole thing. There could be something in it for us if we poke around. There's always the Orc Underground. Haven't seen that yet, have you? I got plenty of friends who are good for a job. Something's bound to come up. What do you say? Think about it, Jake. You do that. You want to find me? I'll be at McCracken's later. Got a taste for some seafood. Take it easy, chummer. The little coroner is surprised to see you, but he can't hide his delight. Hey, Pixel, I was wondering if I was going to see you again. I guess I shouldn't be surprised to find you here. Hey, Dresden, how's my favorite body snatcher? Busy. He pops his eyebrows, eager. You know it's all over the Trivid, right? They found the Emerald City Ripper dead at some asylum out in Snohomish of all places. Turns out he's been masquerading as the head administrator or something. They found him dead from some sort of vigilante attack. He leans in, whispers conspiratorial. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
Why, Mr. Justin, I have no idea what you mean. Justin winks. That's what I thought. Well, no one can say he didn't have it coming, am I right? He frowns to himself. That was a double negative. So, the big question. What about the dead man's switch, now that the Ripper's dead? You going to collect? Right, the dead man's switch. Almost forgot about that. Forgot? Come on. How do you collect? I was told I need a secure line to call the number Sam gave me. Can't use my comlink. He brightens. Lone Star's emergency response team set up a secure phone line right here to coordinate their efforts. I can authorize you to use it. I'll get around to it soon. Great. I'm sure there are other people you want to talk to first. Take care, Pixel. Okay, there's the thing. Alright, I'll talk to Coyote and then I'll use the thing. Guess that's it, huh? You geeked Sam's killer. He's got this justice from beyond the grave. A little more involved than I expected. She looks back at the Universal Brotherhood just a little. Coyote grins. First time. Well, I'm gonna grab Paco, head back to the Union. Maybe watch a trade or something. I could use a long shower too. After that... Back to destroying the beetle trade? Yep, sure as I'm standing here. Going to take a flamethrower to that whole slagging business one squad at a time if I have to. Be careful. The last place was run by the Yakuza, and they're not going to forget you. Her jaw sets, her eyes harden, and she's Coyote again. Let them come. If the Yakuza wants me, they're going to find me. Nothing I can do about that. Some people choose to live in fear, but not me. Not today. Today, I run the shadows. Get paid, get dirty. See you around, Pixel. You're quite a lady. I can honestly say, I've never met anyone quite like you. Damn straight. Alright. Let's do this. The phone before you has a simple numerical keypad. You can use it to call Sam's law firm and cash in on the dead man's switch. You tap in the phone number Sam's lawyer gave you days ago. The phone rings 7 times before someone finally answers. The image of the lawyer on the other end of the vid phone is noticeably different from the one you saw a few days ago. The noise in the background sounds like it's coming from a bar. Yeah? He squints into the phone, and recognition slowly appears on his face. Oh, hey, it's you. Pixel, right? You got Sam's killer, huh? Are you even a lawyer? Yeah, of course. Well, technically I'm not a lawyer anymore, but, I'll just slot Sam's video for you. Hang on. He fumbles for a moment and the camera jerks crazily. Then it goes to static and is replaced by Sam. Good old Sam. Sam still looks like Drek. Same clothes, same background. Probably shot at the same time as the first video. Hey, buddy, looking good. Looking good, he giggles. If you're calling this number, that means the job is done, right? He closes his eyes, shakes his head. Congratulations, amigo. I knew you'd do it. You were always the dependable one. More than me, anyway. He looks back at you, trying to speak soberly. I just want to say thank you for whatever you did. It means a lot. Not even knowing what you did, it still means a lot. Because... I know you did something. You know what I mean? I know you made it right. Somehow. He pauses, tilts his head back. His breath hitches in his chest. You're the only one. The only one who ever gave a... Who ever tried to help me. Ever. Except my sister. She tried. More than once. She tried. I never let her, though. Never let her in, I regret that a lot. Did I ever tell you about her, buddy? We're twins. We're twins, I guess. You're still a twin after one of you dies. I don't know. Doesn't matter, I guess. He sighs heavy. God, listen, do me a favor, will you? If you talk to her, her name is Jessica. Tell her I'm sorry, okay? For everything. She'll know what for. She's Catholic, so she'll forgive me. I need her to forgive me. Just tell her I love her. He straightens himself, shakes it off. That grin is back. Anyway, you need to get paid. Which would be great, except for one thing. I got nothing. Never did. You know how it is, right? Sorry, but hey, thanks again for giving a crap. Seriously, I appreciate it. Tell you what, if you feel sore about it, look into my family background a bit. There's gotta be people with money in there somewhere. Maybe one of them can throw you a few bucks. Take care, amigo. See you in hell. He reaches forward and shuts off the camera. The vid screen goes to static and the call ends. There's a moment of silence, and then you feel a tug on your jacket. It's Dresden. So, what did he say? Never trusted dead men. Thank you. He just said thank you. The Emerald City Ripper killings are sensationalized for several weeks. Lurid reports focus on the killer masquerading as an administrator of Mercy Mental Hospital. Soon after, pop singer Maria Mercurial is cast as the lead in Dr. Ripper, a trivid thriller about a reporter who goes undercover as a mental patient to uncover a serial killer. Seattle Newsnet reports a shootout at the chapter house of the Universal Brotherhood. Witnesses claim that a gang of religious fanatics stormed the building for unknown reasons but committed suicide before they could be captured. All mention of insect spirits, James Telestrian III, or Shadowrunners are kept out of the news. One day later, the city of Chicago declares a quarantine area between Lake Michigan and the Des Plaines River. Officially, the Chicago Containment Zone is established to fight an outbreak of an infectious virus. But an infestation of insect spirits is suspected by those who know. A mature form of Project Aegis called Fabs III is eventually deployed to remove the bug threat from Chicago. The Watts family name has since been lost to the shadows. Yay! Done. I had a feeling I'd finish it tonight. Yeah. Yeah, definitely liked that quite a bit. Good. So I will definitely be continuing the Shadowrun series. My boyfriend told me to do Hong Kong first and then Dragonfall, because it makes more sense chronologically, and then also Dragonfall is the best from what I've heard. So save the best one for last, I guess. And yeah, so I will be doing that, and I'm also going to be playing through South Park Stick of Truth, and because the Fractured Butthole is coming out in December, so I want to get the Stick of Truth played through again. That'll be fun. And I also am going to play Final Fantasy VII soon, because the remake's coming out also in December. So, yeah, that's what I got planned. It'll be fun stuff. I'm really glad I finished this. So, yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next series. Bye.